Well, Arteta blocked Tomiyasu's exit during the summer transfer window, and it was like he had known the potential in him and how he could lift this side of Arsenal to the lost victory. Welcome to the Rokani Media Football. How are you guys and where are you watching us from? I go by the names of Rokan David. Who has gone ahead to break this story? It has been none other than Fabrizio Romano, you know him, number one transfer guru in the world, and has gone ahead and confirmed us that this was a move that Inter Milan was supposed to obviously take on to take out Takahiro Tomiyasu, but Arteta said, you are going nowhere because I see huge potential in you. First video of the day. How are you guys? Hope you're really having a fantastic stay. This is Rokan David on the Rokani Media Football. Smash the like button close to 300 times and don't forget to subscribe to this channel so as not to miss out on stories that we do upload in here on a daily. Now today, we are really having a huge match, you know, United taking on Manchester City. If at all you want to see all the gist, United Matters channel is the place to be. And let's discuss what this Arsenal side has to say about this. So, Fabrizio Romano has gone ahead and obviously put out a tweet that Arsenal rejected Inter approach in July for Takahiro Tomiyasu. You know, and Arteta has gone ahead to say, I love him. Everybody loves him. He's one of the most popular in the dressing room. He's always very reserved and always doing things for the rest of the boys. He's a fantastic player for the team. That's what Arteta has gone ahead to say. Now, Takahiro Tomiyasu was brought in at Arsenal from Bologna, that is in Serie A. He costed Arsenal £18 million, or €20 million. And they brought him at Arsenal, and he is obviously doing wonders. And the Japanese Magico is obviously trying to thrive under the management of Mikel Arteta. We all know that he has been having a very, very, very bad injury record at Arsenal ever since the injury he got in the March of 2021. Remember, they signed him in the March of 2022. That is it. So they signed him in the summer of 2021 from Bologna. And he's one of those deadline day transfers that Arsenal went ahead to make, and they brought him. And trust me, he went ahead to fit into that Arsenal team like a glove. That is it. He was a perfect fit of a signing that he was playing as a right back for Arsenal. Gabriel Magalhaes and Ben White were playing to the central defense, as Ben White was playing as a right-sided center back, and Gabriel Magalhaes was playing as a left-handed center back. And Kieran Tierney and Nuno Tavares, we are sharing the role to play as the left back of the club of Arsenal. So, no one saw to it that Ben White would ever even come in through and play the right back position of Arsenal. And that was led to the injury of Tomiyasu. Tomiyasu played his first two-thirds of the season very well. And the last third, he was injured in March. That is in 2022. Now, we waited and saw to it that he goes under surgery, and when he went under surgery, guess what happened? He missed out until I think the last two games of the season, where they anticipated his return, and his return was not really seen. So after that, he returned during the international break, during the preseason. He trained with Arsenal, and they went to Munich. They went to Nuremberg, they went to America, and then he returned. But the injuries kept being recurring. That is it. The injuries kept being recurring. He went to the World Cup. He never played most, I think, the first game because of how injured he was. And when he returned at Arsenal, he underwent surgery. That is it. After undergoing surgery, he returned, I think, around February. And he returned and really played some games. After playing some games, he got an injury that kept him out until the end of the season, when Arsenal was playing against Sporting Lisbon. Remember that game of the, I think it was the round of 16. It was like the round of 16 where Arsenal were knocked out by Sporting Lisbon. And he got injured with William Saliba, if at all you had to remember very well. He was injured with William Saliba, and till then, he never kicked a ball that season. So we waited and waited and waited. He returned in the preseason, and they gave him the required treatment, and he is finally here. doing what everyone is calling magic. He has been one of those players that Arteta is going to hate to really look at a lot this season, and is going to hate to produce lots of fruitful results for Arsenal. And that's what makes Mikel Arteta a genius of seeing ahead. I've always told you that it said the wise see ahead, and Mikel Arteta went ahead to see ahead by calling in for his stay, because when you look at Inter Milan, they had lost Skriniar on a free and they wanted a player like Tomiyasu. So Tobias is a versatile player. There is no position in the four back positions that he cannot obviously play. He can play literally in every position. That is Tomiyasu. He can play as a right back, he can play as a left back, he can play as a central defender, either on the right or the right sided center back. He thrives well that side. So to me, I think Arteta got it right. Tomiyasu is a very good player, and I really told you at the start of the season that one of the players at Arsenal that is really playing his last season or prolonged his season at Arsenal is Tomiyasu. If he doesn't keep himself fit, I think Arteta will let him go next season. That's the same thing that Thomas Partey is really facing. Thomas Partey has been an injury-prone player at the club of Arsenal, and there is no way Arteta can obviously not sell him next season, you know? So, it remains to see whether he will be sold or not sold, but on a higher percentage, he's obviously going to be sold by Arsenal. Now, when we go to Tomiyasu, some of the highlights, I was going to hate to put up this season, it was when Arsenal was playing Brentford in the Carabao Cup. When Arsenal was playing Brentford in the Carabao Cup, they found themselves in a situation of obviously going ahead to really win that game by 1-0, and that back line was obviously solid. We saw Tomiyasu first played as a right back, and then he was shifted into the central defense, you know. And then in the last 10 minutes of the game, Arsenal was playing with the back three, you know, Yakub Kivio, Tomiyasu, and Gabriel Magalhaes. That's what really happened into that fixture. So Arsenal put up a show, and they obviously had to win the game. The other show that he put up was when Arsenal were playing Man City. The secondary assist that he put up with his header that was really directed with precision to Kai Havertz. Kai Havertz controlled the ball and really passed it to Martinelli, and Martinelli hit that ball and it went the back of the net. Now, the other game where he put up a masterclass performance was that of Chelsea. Remember, Chelsea had gone ahead to really realize that there is a weakness in the defensive abilities of Zinchenko. And that's why you said to it that Raheem Sterling and Palmer were obviously drawing themselves that side. And they caused a lot of trouble, and Zinchenko was in a yellow card. So what Arteta did, he took him off at the beginning of the second half and brought in Tomiyasu. And Tomiyasu closed that area, hence having stability in the entire back line. Then after that, he went to Sevilla in Spain. You saw what he did. The Arsenal fans voted for him as their player of the match. He put up a show. Him, Declan Rice, put up a show. But because of the abilities and the work rate and the output that Gabriel Jesus went ahead to put up during that beautiful fixture, as Arsenal won Sevilla by 2-1, he found himself in a situation of really being named the man of the match by the Champions League and we here onto the channel. So, I think that was not all until when he came on yesterday and really scored a goal. His first goal for Arsenal, and he's obviously thriving. But all this goes back to the trust that Mikel Arteta has going to have to invest into this player, the Japanese international, because injuries have been part of his career for a very, very long time. And he's here to obviously get himself back to where he deserves to be. So Arteta blocked Tomiyasu's exit. Fabrizio Romano has gone ahead and really confirmed it to us. And now I throw the ball back to you, the viewers of Rakan Media Football. Do you think Mikel Arteta did the best decision to obviously keep Tomiyasu here? Yes or no? Because it's all about the manager. Sometimes When a team wins, the comments or the commendations go to the players, and the managers are really forgotten. The managers are only hailed when the team obviously loses. Sorry, are criticized when the team really loses. When the team is winning, the players are good. When the team is losing, the manager is bad. So I think Arteta deserves his flowers, and we should give him his flowers today. And I think you guys are going to be coming in through and letting me know what your thoughts are about this. So I sign up for now. See you later. Off to the United Matters channel as we obviously bring you the match day live of Manchester United versus Manchester City. Go on and obviously subscribe. We want to hit 18,000 subscribers before the end of this month, and hope you guys obviously are going to make it. May the living to God bless you abundantly. The Muslims, Barakallahu Fikum. Rokan David remains my name. And let's see close to 300 likes much in this video. Not so? I'm out. Let me go to the other channel, our sister channel, United Matters channel. I'm out.